So this project is being brought to you by a partnership between the Prince George's County Planning Department, the Better Block Foundation, and Creative Suitland. Here are photos of the project leads who you will hopefully get to know as we get to know you throughout this process. Before our partners speak, however, I do want to give a brief overview of the project and talk about how we got here. So Placemaking Suitland is the first of three pilot projects initiated by the Prince George's County Planning Department to advance placemaking throughout the county. For those unfamiliar with the definition of placemaking, because there are tons of different definitions floating around, but I borrowed one from Project for Public Spaces that says that placemaking refers to a collaborative process by which we can shape our public realm in order to maximize shared value. It facilitates creative patterns of use, paying particular attention to the physical, cultural, and social identities that define a place and support its ongoing evolution. Now, if any of you have ever been to Creative Suitland, you know that they are very familiar with placemaking. And, you know, I've been there a number of times and I've seen that they use markets, they use the outdoor concert series and other programs to promote arts and to enhance the sense of place and community in Suitland. So for us, they were an obvious partner for this initiative. Furthermore, Suitland is designated as a regional transit district in Plan 2035, which is the county's general plan. This is one of the county's guiding documents that sets forth the vision and the strategy for growth and development in the county. Some of the goals are to create more choice communities and create walkable urban places. So this placemaking initiative will hopefully move us closer to realizing and achieving our short and long-term goals. Now, because this is a new initiative for the planning department, we enlisted the expertise of the Better Block Foundation to help execute our three pilot projects. And again, this is the first of three pilot projects. In a moment, you'll hear from Kristen, who is with the Better Block Foundation, to talk about some of the work that they've done with activating streets and other public spaces to elevate the sense of place in communities around the country. But before she speaks and talks about their organization and their program, I want to kick it off to Malachi with Creative Suitland to talk briefly about their organization and their programming. So Malachi, take it away.
All righty. Thank you, Christina. And hello, everyone. Well, good evening, everybody. My name is Malachi Robinson, as mentioned, and I'm the director of Creative Suitland Arts Center. Just wanted to review or just discuss a few items that Creative Suitland has done as it relates to creative placemaking over the past 2 years, and kind of define, and hopefully within that define what we see as creative placemaking in Suitland and how this partnership with the county, Park and Planning, and Better Block Foundation will help us to get to that overall vision of what we want to see for this Greater Suitland community, and finish off with just some long-term goals that we have for the community. So as we have here, Creative Suitland, we opened our doors in February of 2020. We actually closed our doors in March 2020, at least the physical space. We transferred all of our programming to a virtual platform, as a lot of arts organizations did during that time, and found a lot of great success in that realm. But going back to creative placemaking, that gave us a lot of time to actually get really into the nuts and bolts of defining creative placemaking for the student community. So within that time frame that we closed the doors, we actually started the planning process of our creative placemaking initiative, which is titled Empty Spaces to Creative Places. And if anyone wants to know more information about that, feel free to go to our website, creativesuitland.org. But just to define a little bit about that initiative and where we are to date, once the pandemic began, like I said, we started this planning process for our Creative Placemaking Initiative, and actually in March of 2021, so a year a year ago, almost a year ago, we started our parking lot mural project, which is one of the first projects we launched under the initiative, which seeks to commission local artists, visual artists, painters, et cetera, to design and install their own mural designs on a parking lot. We have a pretty large parking lot. If you haven't been to Creative Suitland before, there's like a little short example there on that picture on the bottom left, but shows like a small portion of it. But we have about 80 to 100 spaces, parking spaces, and we want to transform 50, at least 50 of those spaces into mural designs. Initially, we'll create this large quilt of different designs and marketing from different artists and just putting their own stamp on our space. Like I said, in that picture in the lower left, you can kind of see a little bit of the design as well as the parking lot space. And also you can kind of see how we've transformed the exterior facade of the building. It originally was a church, Hunt Memorial AME Church, which, you know, was in that location for some years, and they sold the building and moved to another location. And we moved in a few years after that. And as you can see, we transformed the front exterior facade from the existing mostly white exterior and transformed it into a mural. And actually with that, going along with that mural, that was the second part of our Creative Placemaking initiative, which was to commission a notable Suitland High School alum, if anyone's familiar with Naturelle, who has done a lot of work with reputable brands like Nike and Puma. We commissioned him to design and install the mural and also support our Community Paint Day, which was our way of making this a community activity and bringing out the local Suitland residents to actually put the final touches on the mural and put their own stamp on it so that they feel involved and feel welcome in our space. And it just adds the sense of community, adds the sense of appreciation for the arts and for their own community, and just having something in the central part of Prince George's County that they can, you know, call home and be a part of. That is the mural. We've also done outdoor markets, as you see in that lower picture on the left. We've had outdoor markets during the market season from last June to October, and we plan to bring that back this year. So that's our poetry and produce program, which has poetry readings, of course, farmers, local vendors, open mic, interactive visual art stations, and just creating a creative experience for families and for local residents. Again, you know, we don't see this type of activity in our part of the county, so it's our mission to really bring these type of activities specifically to Greater Suitland and the central part of Prince George's County. And the last picture that you see there on the right is just part of our outdoor programming that we've done, that we've rolled out over the past year to really activate our outdoor space, even before we even put the final touches on the project that we're working with Better Block and Park and Planning. But we just wanted to get a head start and really just activate the space and allow outdoor activities for teens. As you see there, there's a yoga and mindfulness program that we launched last summer, specifically for teens, free of charge, in partnership with the county again. And we look forward to doing that again this year and finding other ways to bring outdoor activities to Suitland. Because if anyone's been to Creative Suitland site, you know, we have a very visible visible building, and we want to make sure that when people pass by, they see that we're there and this momentum builds outward. So we extend to the Suitland Metro Station all the way down to Suitland High School, which goes into my next point, which is the future of creative placemaking in Suitland. Our long-term vision is to transform the Suitland Silver Hill Road corridor into an arts walk. And ideally that arts walk will be comprised of public art installations, more murals, outdoor performances, and other ways to really just transform the corridor, because it's a very busy corridor of, I think it's a 3 or 6 lane highway, and there's just a lot of traffic and a lot of visibility, and we want to make sure that people have some sense of pride in this part of the county and within the greater Suitland community. So all that being said, you know, we look forward to this partnership with Park and Planning and with the Better Block team, just so that we can finally implement this project. That's, I feel like, what, 2 years in the making because of the pandemic. So it's a long time coming, but the results are going to be well worth it. So looking forward to hearing your feedback and your comments, and hopefully you all will get involved with the project. And that is all I have.
Thank you, Malika. And so now we're going to kick it over to Kristen with the Better Block Foundation. And I'm going to ask Kristen that she share her screen so that she can present and talk about the work that they do and what they foresee in Suitland. So Kristen, you can take it away.
Sure, let me get my screen all set up. Hey everyone, my name is Kristen Leiber. I am the Senior Project Manager for the Better Block Foundation. Let me get my, there you go. Yeah, like I said, Senior Project Manager for the Better Block Foundation. I'm excited to talk to you guys tonight. We get to travel the world doing placemaking demonstrations for communities like yourselves. And we've had the opportunity to work with Prince George's County now for a couple of years. And we've been really just waiting for a while to finally get to be on the ground in Suitland. So we're really thrilled to chat with you all tonight and kick this off. I'm going to present a slideshow. I promise I'll keep it short. It's just that a picture says 1,000 words. And I think this project will make a lot of sense with the visuals. I'm going to finish off with talking about kind of the timeline and the things we're looking for and next steps from the community. And finally, how you guys can be of help. And then at the end, we'll open it up for Q&A. If you guys have questions or would like to give some feedback on direction, those of you who know Creative Suitland and love it, those of you who live in Suitland and are passionate about your community, we welcome your feedback. So that's a little roadmap for where we're heading. I will start us off, though, by giving us a bit of history about the Better Block. So about 10 years ago, our founder, Jason Roberts, got started in a neighborhood that looked like this. This is just a few blocks from our office in Oak Cliff, which is a suburb of Dallas, a little neighborhood of Dallas. He looked around at this site and said, you know, why when we go to walkable cities or we go on vacation or a long weekend to a great city, we're going to places with outdoor dining and sidewalk flowers and compelling sidewalks. And when we come home, this is the sidewalk we get here. What's the difference between these places we want to vacation and the places we live and why? And so he kind of dove into city policy. He found that there were ordinances that were from the 40s that said, you know, sidewalk flowers will cost you $1,000 and street cafe seating will cost you this bizarre formula of area times market value times 12%. And there are even restrictions on crowds congregating. So he realized that if you want to kill street life, this is how you do it. He went forward and he joined up with some neighbors. Over the course of a weekend, they pulled together all the things they wished their neighborhood looked and felt like. So they used kids paint and duct tape to repave the street, to reline the streets, to add bike lanes. They brought sidewalk flowers out. They pulled their furniture out and added sidewalk seating. They did pop-up restaurants. They took the vacant storefronts and they activated them with the pop-up neighborhood shops their neighbors had. And they even pulled things out on the sidewalk to have a real sidewalk presence of someone shopping, you know, similar to a walkable neighborhood in New York or in Europe. So they did this, and what they did is they invited city council out. They asked if they would, how they felt about the project, and they loved it. And then they also had posted the rules they were breaking in the windows. So they weren't sure if they'd get in trouble or be, you know, be praised. They ended up being praised. City council saw the point that they were trying to make, realized that these ordinances were outdated and needed adjustment. And so over the following years, they were able to do away with and relook at some of these policies that were on their books. From there, we've done a lot of projects over the US, and some of our work has even made it internationally. We're really looking forward to our first international trip this year. We're in a little old kind of converted car garage, gas station from the 50s or so in Oak Cliff. We are part makerspace and part office. So we use a lot of the materials you see here to activate public spaces. A typical project of ours that you'll look at when we come into an area, this is very different than Creative Suitland, which is kind of a unique project. But when we're looking at cityscapes, we're looking at places like this. We're looking for four main criteria. One is the streets. Are they overbuilt? Are they too wide? Are they walkable? How many people are driving on them? Are they too large for how many people are driving? What's the quality like? You know, there's a lot of things that go into streetscapes. What are the sidewalks like? Is it safe? Do people feel safe when they're walking or biking? The second thing we look at is the commercial activity. We look to see what's going on here. Are there vacant storefronts? Are there active storefronts? What are the small business owners like and how long have they been here? What are they selling and is there an interest in trying something new or in having better support for these existing small businesses? Finally, we look at the neighborhood around this. Where is the community? Are they just beyond, you know, these commercial storefronts, or is their neighborhood a bit further away? What do they do for fun here? What would they like to see in their neighborhood? What are the changes they would like to make? And finally, we look for potential of future changes. Is this an area where we could potentially see future permanent change? Are the property owners willing to work with us? Is the city willing to try something new in master planning efforts? So it's really about potential and then the things that are there today that can really be considered assets. So a lot of times when you put that all together, you create an event that's for the community that incorporates all of these things. So there's an element of small business and community. There's an element of hope for the future changes that could be in a place and really a fantastic way to have, you know, support small businesses that come together as a neighborhood and experience some quality time, much needed after the past few years. So we do this in a few ways. One is our wiki block. This is our open sourced library of CNC furniture. If you're not familiar with a CNC router, this is essentially a wood printer. It will cut sheets of 4x8 plywood into shapes. And what we do is using mallets, we can friction fit them together. So you don't have to be a carpenter to build some of these placemaking elements. We can build over the course of just a few minutes, all sorts of things ranging from big public space furniture like benches and tables all the way to, you know, architectural elements or even kids play furniture. It's just some examples of what we've done in the past, just to give you guys a sense of where we start and where we usually land. In Duluth, Minnesota, this was a winter project. So we were looking at a big paved corner lot, kind of like this. And over the course of a few days and at 30 degree weather, we were able to bring in some architectural elements, creating a better bus stop shelter. We incorporated community and food trucks and lighting and really made a cozy spot that people wanted to come spend time at. In Toronto, a few years ago, we worked on a Vision Zero project, which was all about preventing pedestrian deaths from car accidents. And so we took a look at an overbuilt road, very busy with a lot of commercial activity. And we tried some fairly unintuitive things. We took away some parking. We took away some of the roadway. The small businesses were concerned about the impact on their business, but it actually increased. And we saw a large increase in activity in the area. A lot of people biking safely. We saw music and really the sidewalks come alive. So we really enjoyed seeing this one come to life permanently about a year later when City Council made this permanent with some slight tweaks. So it really embraced the Better Block vision of being iterative and a community-led project to make it their own. In Vickery Meadow, we had a slightly bigger project. This was looking at a five-point intersection in one of the highest crime areas of Dallas. Just off the screen, there's a middle school that many kids would walk to and from every day through this pretty dangerous, hard to navigate intersection. Dangerous from a car standpoint and dangerous from a criminal and safety standpoint. So we worked with the local businesses, the kids, the neighbors living there. And over the course of a few weeks, we were able to transform this into a plaza that lasted for a year. This one was creating a space for small business pop-ups in the shipping container. It created a little bit of nature where there had been none before, so it had some park elements to it. There was a stage, there were swings. There were things for you to do and enjoy in this space and come together as a community in a space that was formerly fairly hostile, both architecturally and from a safety perspective. So you can see here from a human height that we were using this for a pop-up library in the shipping container. We added elements of seating. We had added string lights, and it really brought a lot of warmth to the area. This one was our first kind of adventure into addressing crime through the changes in the public environment. So this one was a success. We had some great outcomes from it, and there's still been no violent crimes in this plaza area. Here, I think we are 2 years later. Quincy, this was one we did, in 2021. This is in Washington State. This one we were looking at a more rural setting. We had a street that was near the center of a small town that was focused on agriculture, really overbuilt, wide roads that had more than enough space for people, but one thing, or more than enough space for cars. But one thing you couldn't tell was that there were spaces for people on the right and left. There was a winery, a great rec center, a popping restaurant and bar, and it was just not really interactive from a sidewalk standpoint. So over the course of a few days, we did a road diet. We made an adjustment from the space for cars and the space for people, and we turned this into a farmer's market and kind of a winery event. So this was really about people reclaiming car space for people. You can see the speed of our work. So we really work fast when we say it's a quick process. This is over the course of just a few days, and I believe this project will even be a little quicker than that. So this is through community-led volunteer or community-led volunteer approach. We work together with you guys to muralize, to build, to activate, to program, and it builds a really engaging, warm event. This is kind of a breakdown of a typical site view. There's a lot of different activities going on, and it's all reflective of what the community would like to see. This is also an example from the same project of how we use local assets to really make each project feel like it is it's special to this particular area, this particular neighborhood. So this one on the left, you can see there were these are actually apple crates. This is a very agricultural region, and we use these to build a stage. So it's really incorporating something that was fairly common in the area, but would make for a really unique stage setup. And on the right, you can see us muralizing out their local high school mascot, which is the jackrabbit. We bring in, you can see the elements of games, shade, lighting. These are kiosks that we have in our Wiki Block catalog to help accommodate, like we had brewers or a winery all the way to farmers market the next morning. So it's really a multi-use flexible space. Just some of our volunteers doing their good work. It's a really fun, engaging event where you can swing a hammer or get dirty with some paint and really put some elbow grease towards building an important community event that can have legs and go on to some really important changes in the future. Just a few images, of course, we have of the event really coming to life, and that's through the community. So it's the neighbors, it's the people who come to this event, who program it, who are dancing or performing or sharing their talents in other ways with the neighborhood and the Better Block event that will really bring this to life. So this is our favorite moment always. It's after the hard work has been done from a build perspective, and it's when the community just gets to get together and enjoy themselves. We have a little bit of feedback here, but I think the important part is to know that these resources already exist there. We are here to help demonstrate the process of how you go about organizing and mobilizing, pulling permits where needed. But the important part is bringing community together and using your resources to make this happen in a way that feels reflective of what you guys would like to see. We say we do these Better Blocks for several reasons. The first is for change. We follow up with our projects, and we see a lot of statistical feedback that's important from our projects. So there's things that go on long after we're gone. There's increases in community engagement, in ongoing programming, in permanent street changes to an area. We see changes in even perception, street life, and possibly the most important sometimes is newly formed CDCs and communities that haven't had any formal representation at a city level or nonprofit structure. So it's really exciting to see these things continue on after we go and we have shown the community what it's like to ideate as a group. We also do this for Instagram because a picture says 1,000 words. You want to show and incentivize people, help them envision things or imagine things where they are not maybe able to do that before. So we use these events as an opportunity to help people see what potential changes could look like permanently before they are made permanent and before that expense and the planning is done. So it's a great way to iterate, find things that can be tweaked and make adjustments as you move on as a neighborhood. And finally, we do this for love. We always say that We build for love, not for fear. And I think that's truer than ever. There are lots of what-if scenarios that we can tell ourselves. There's a lot of potential things that could go wrong. And that's part of the reason why we keep our projects fast. We don't overmeet. We don't overthink. A lot of times we can talk ourselves out of good ideas. So we go with what the community's instincts are, and we bring them to life over the course of about 90 to 120 days. So this project will be no different. We're looking forward to a quick win and a quick, quick beautification project for the neighborhood around Creative Suitland. Okay, that's it for, this is the wrong email address, but my name's Kristen at Better Block. I'll share my email in the chat. But I wanted to dive just briefly into the Creative Suitland project. We are right at the beginning, so I appreciate you all joining us for this kickoff. We are looking at this site, which you may or may not have seen before, but this is an overhead shot of Creative Suitland. We have seen a lot of work that's been done by Creative Suitland team, so it does not look like this any longer, but you'll see a lot of paint on the ground in the parking lot. You'll see changes made to the building front. You'll see murals, you'll see artwork, but we would like to add to that. So I think what we're looking at is kind of making adjustments to this square blue area. Wondering what as a community you guys would like to see. We're sort of all ears right now. What does the community need to see? What would you guys like to see? What would you like to see specifically with outdoor elements, something representative of Suitland or something involving the arts? We're sort of all ears and we're very excited to make it happen. I did want to give a little bit of framework. One element of our partnership with Prince George's County's Placemaking Division was that we worked on a shipping container that is staying with the county, and it has elements needed for a basic event in it. So we've got picnic tables and shade, we've got generators, we've got a container that folds out into a storefront, lots of seating, lots of fun things that can help convert a parking lot into a fun space to be. So the goal of this project is to add to that with elements that are custom or desired just by this neighborhood that can be left behind with Creative Suitland. This is a mouthful, but this is our website for the project where you can follow along. We've got volunteer workshops that will be popping up here. You can sign up for those. Right now, we are looking for a few volunteers who'd like to help lead this project. Everything from people with experience in carpentry to people, marketing folks who know how to work social media. Really anyone who's got a vision for the area and a passion for Suitland, and for this project in particular, a passion for the arts. Please reach out through that website. We would love to get in touch with you. Next steps, I'm sure you all would love to know. So our, in short order, volunteer workshops are going to be live, and they will be happening April 5th through 8th. The placemaking event itself is going to be taking place April 8th through 9th. So that is when that week we will be on the ground, and that's when we'll be celebrating with you that weekend, Friday and Saturday, the 8th and 9th. For now, I would love to hear both tonight through the Q&A session and after you've given it a little thought, any ideas you might have. This is my email address, kristen@betterblock.org. Anything ranging from vendors, small businesses, artists, any potential partners, any potential builds you think might be good for Creative Suitland, we would love to hear them. I know Creative Suitland has a lot of ideas already, so you might see a couple things already in action there. And finally, share information about this event. This is inclusive. We're wanting to represent everyone in the neighborhood. So no matter whether you are, 2 or 100, we have something you can help with the volunteer workshop. We have space for you, both from an infrastructure standpoint, accessibility standpoint, and from a programming standpoint. So we would really love to see everyone come join us. I will just drop in the website one more time. For those of you who haven't written it down, this is the county's kind of headquarters for their placemaking and pilot projects. So it's a good website just to have anyways. So with that, I am very excited to get started with you all. I think I'd like to open it up for Q&A now, if there's no trouble with that, Christina, and I'm happy to answer any questions with the understanding that we are just getting started. We probably don't have all the answers yet, but would love to talk about our process or any ideas you might have.
Thank you, Kristen. And I just dropped in the chat the link to the volunteer form that Kristen just mentioned, as well as the link to the project page where you can learn more about the project, the initiative from our standpoint, and you'll see it'll have a link to the volunteer form again. So I've just enabled everyone's microphones. Please do not unmute all at the same time, but we certainly would like to hear your feedback, hear your suggestions, hear your praise, or whatever you want to talk about related to the project. And it might be helpful if you know, we do start hearing a lot of people jump in at once, if you would raise your hand using the raise hand feature at the top of the screen beside the chat feature. You know, we'll monitor that, but essentially, you know, this is your opportunity to share your thoughts and let us know how you would like to participate. So David, I see that you have your hand raised and your microphone should be enabled. So go ahead and ask your question.
Hey, thanks a lot. Can you guys hear me? I had to go and unmute. Awesome. Yep. First of all, really impressive. My name is Dave Owens. I actually don't live in Suitland, but I'm down in the Fort Washington area. Kristen, very impressive stuff. Love to hear what you guys are doing. And Adam, you know me, I've talked to you a couple of times. You guys are doing great work as well. A question I had, Kristen, was you're working with the Suitland area. Is that public property? Is it private property? And as you go around the country and you work in these areas, what difference does that make when you're working with public or private? Does it make a difference? And what are some of those roadblocks that you come across when you work across the country?
Yeah, I will. I'll let Malachi and Brooke answer the question about public or private property for Creative Suitland. However, as Better Block, we work in both. We see, you know, as one of the four things that we look for in a project, one of the main ones is potential for future change. And sometimes that goes hand in hand with a private property owner. That has to be the right property owner, though, right? So oftentimes we find ourselves working in a mix of both. And we certainly do a lot of work on the permitting side. We work with roadways, so that's definitely public property. We work with a lot of sidewalks, small business development. We work with, you know, sort of activating private spaces usually to help people envision what it could possibly be used for. So let's say it's a vacant lot and no one has any clue what its use could be. We might try out a, you know, a park or a, you know, a hiking trail or something. We might put in some small businesses or some structural elements, and people can really start wrapping their heads around potential uses. So it really just depends on where we're working and the type of community we're in, and of course the appetite for change from whoever we're working with.
Thanks a lot, and again, great work. We've been keeping track of what you guys and ladies are doing, and it's good stuff, so really appreciate it.
Thank you.
So we have a few more hands raised. We have a caller on the line, number ending in 8056. If you want to go ahead and ask your question.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, we can.
Hi, this is Pat Lindsay, and I just want to say I'm just so excited about everything that is taking place with Creative Suitland. And I work at the Anacostia Community Museum, and of course, you know, we are a museum that sits in the heart of Anacostia, also in a community. And this project sounds similar to what we had to do. The museum, except the grounds were not inviting. And so what we wanted the neighborhood to feel like they would be a part of the community. So what we did a couple of years ago, we totally revamped the outside of the museum, made it more eco-friendly, and by putting an outdoor exhibit And with just that little project, well, it was a very expensive project, but it made the neighborhood feel like they were very much a part of the museum. And it felt like, because, you know, before we did that, they would just walk by the museum, never came in. But once we put that outdoor exhibit and totally changed the landscaping and put in a permanent outdoor exhibit, it brings more people onto the grounds of the museum. So I'm just excited about what you guys are doing. I've been a part of Creative Suitland since the conception of the idea. And so anything that I can do to volunteer my efforts, I'm so happy to do so. And I'm just so excited about all the things that are coming.
Yeah, you sound like a placemaker already. We're excited to have you on board.
Awesome. Bernetta.
Bernetta, you got it right. Thank you. yeah, I echo everyone else's sentiment as far as just being really excited about what we're hearing today. This is my first time learning about Creative Suitland. I've been a resident here in Suitland for many, many years, and I'm a graduate of Suitland High School. So I am heavily invested in this community, and I care deeply about these efforts. I have a few questions, and then just to kind of highlight some of the areas, I already filled out the volunteer form. So my background is a lot, comms, marketing, strategic planning, project and program management, even event management. So I'll get involved wherever you need me, but some of my questions today are, one, who else are you partnering with, or do you have plans to partner with other organizations? On one of the slides, you had workshops planned for April, so I'm curious to see, do you know where those are going to be held? Are they in-person or virtual? Is your focus just arts-based, or are you looking to expand that focus? And have you identified specific areas within Suitland that you know you already want to work on? Okay.
Sure. I am definitely going to forget one of those questions, so just remind me. The project will take place on the Creative Suitland site, so we have that focus right now. No, I do not think we are limited to the arts. We have a great partner already with Creative Suitland here, so I am counting on this being a heavy arts focus. However, there's always elements of other things in our project, and it's totally dictated by the community needs. So if it's resources, we will go out and find those at the city level. If it is, childhood education or childhood kind of a parks approach, we'll go tackle that. If it's small business support, if it's some sort of community event that needs the community would like to see recurring, like a market or a First Friday sort of situation, we'll explore that. So this is really where we're starting. We're starting at the ground floor here. So we are totally open to suggestions for partners. Right now it is the county and Creative Suitland and Better Block. And we are open for all the partnerships that would like to join. The format of the event, I know we have a few thoughts just because Creative Suitland has so many amazing artists and performers. So we have a few thoughts there already, but I think cross-disciplinary, cross-functional events are amazing. And I think we will be exploring everything that you guys have to offer as Suitland. So yes, all welcome. And I think I forgot one of your questions.
That was great though. The other one was, where are the workshops being held in April?
Yeah, so, obviously, this is a weird year. So generally, our workshops are outdoors on site. So we will be at Creative Suitland. We generally have an AM and a PM workshop. We also have events like volunteer opportunities if you want to come help us, you know, count people and keep an eye on things. So we'll have definitely in-person opportunities. There may or may not be some virtual opportunities. So let me get back to you on that one. But I know we are in a world where we need to be sensitive to people's comfort levels. So we will figure something out.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
And before we go to Jordan and then Alexandria, I want to just add to what Kristen said. I want to ask you, Kristen, if you could just briefly talk about kind of timing from today until April, because this kickoff meeting that we're having now is for the event in April. So there will be plenty of work that needs to be done between now and that the main event in April. So if you can just kind of give, you know, your elevator speech about the timing or the timeline.
Yeah, I'll give you a very brief, non-detailed kind of overview. So for the next month, give or take, we are seeking feedback. We're talking to people. We're fielding some like outreach. We're talking to the city. We're talking to nonprofits. We're talking to neighbors. The month after that, we're designing. So we're taking all that feedback from the community, and we are putting together some ideas of build, of event ideas, of, you know, murals, whatever it is the community would like to see. We are going to be exploring that. So we kind of go back and forth with our leadership team, which I skipped over. So Creative Suitland is obviously one of our partners, but we're looking for more community partners to help be on our leadership team. We call them block captains, but we have smaller opportunities for leads, volunteer leads, marketing leads, that kind of thing. So we're looking for those over the course of the next month too. I'd really like to have that team figured out by early February. We'll be doing weekly meetings after starting with the design and starting with the design time, and then all the way through April, we'll be planning it out. It should be a fairly small time commitment. And then from there, we'll be building on site. Our team does a lot of behind the scenes work with permits where needed or ordering materials. So it's a little less busy than for the leadership team. But then on site, we're there for a full week. We're building, we're painting, we're talking, we're, you know, block walking. We're doing a lot of stuff. So that's when we really come together as a community, and we kind of teach how to fish, teach how to throw these events. And then we throw a bit, what feels like a big fun party, but is really an exercise in urban design, community work, and placemaking that Friday, Saturday. And then from there we leave. And the goal is for the leave behind to be the momentum. And of course, the things that are staying at Creative Suitland. So we would not like to see the event end there. We would like to see this exercise in leadership and creative placemaking continue on long after we're gone. So we're really trying to teach what we know and then hand the keys over to you guys.
Thanks, Kristen. So Jordan, we'll go to you next.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Thanks for having me. I would echo the previous comments that as a long-term, actually 20-year resident of Suitland, I actually live in Morningside. I'm extremely excited to learn about this project. I know that other areas in the county had benefited from this type of economic development. And I know that your, you know, initial question was recommendations for the space. You already mentioned one that I think is just obvious, which is the option for market. This is a food desert. There is an initiative with, I know, the state of Maryland that they host farmers markets across the state. I think that that would be a great opportunity for us to bring in permanent access to fruits, fresh fruits and vegetables, outside of the gentleman that currently is a vendor who sets up on Marlboro Pike and provides those types of goods. I think it's unofficial. So I think a market, a farmer's market, a reoccurring permanent farmer's market is imperative. The other thing is, when you think about arts, arts in the schools is suffering. And there is a project, it's actually out of Philadelphia. It's called Playwrights of Philly. But I'm thinking of a similar concept as it relates to bringing in the arts programs from the neighboring schools, and not just the senior schools, because the transition away from art in the early stages is prevalent, especially in the jazz genre. Like, literally, they are looking for young musicians to become interested in jazz. I know that one of the speakers mentioned she's associated with the Anacostia Museum, and there was a gentleman out of Anacostia who ran a jazz program for many years, and that, although that's in the city, those are the type of programs that this location can benefit from. I actually patronized the Anacostia Museum, and to see some of the programs and the workshops that they host there to be available in my local community would be ideal. I would also say that I plan to volunteer. I work very closely with the small business community in the federal environment, and I've also worked very closely with the small business community in the state and local. So I think I could be a great benefit there. I think your comment about bringing in small business vendors is definitely something that should be included in this process. And I guess my question would be, because I'm just learning about this initiative and I'm so glad I participated. You said there's a 2-day event and then you all pack up and leave it with the community. Who are the stewards of that, space once you all leave?
Right. So the container was something purchased as an asset for the community by the county. So the planning division here, or the placemaking division here, is who's going to manage that. So I'm sure they are your person to talk to. They are your people to talk to if you'd like to talk about using that in the future. It will have everything, you know, kind of the basics: seating, lighting, power, shade, that kind of thing, to transform a parking lot. The other things will be left behind, primarily with Creative Suitland, for them to continue activating within Suitland for their nonprofit. So that we'll leave as much as we can behind. We generally have quite a few fun things we leave back, and we like to see them keep being reused over and over.
Thank you. Let's go to Alexandria.
Hello, can you hear me all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Good evening. My name is Alexandria Wilson. I'm actually the facility director at Suitland Community Center, which is not far from Creative Suitland. So I'm really excited to see that this space is coming on board. I guess for today, I'm more interested in just trying to see how I can be a partner along with. I think this seems like a really exciting project, that there's a lot of new stuff that we're trying to, enhance in the department. We just had a new playground that we worked with a partnership with Kaboom, BGE, and Pepco to create this past fall in October. And this seems like another great project coming on board as well to enhance the Suitland area. So I'm really excited to see more things are happening and would love to see how I can, you know, assist with this project, but also get more involved with Creative Suitland as well. So.
Thank you.
That's wonderful, and I am actively seeing the those of you who are signing up for our using the volunteer form. I'm seeing those emails come in. We can drop in the link. I'm sorry, in the chat one more time, the link to the volunteer form. So for all of you who are expressing this excitement and really want to volunteer, certainly go to that form so you can volunteer for this event. And actually, I'm going to have Malachi, if you don't mind, put your email address in the chat so that they can get in touch with you directly and talk about how there might be some synergies with their organization and Creative Suitland. So I am going to go back to David.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say anything else. I just the caller before last mentioned to Kristen about some of the natural partners as you were looking for, and she was talking about the arts community, and I would echo those thoughts. I would say this: I know that as you look for those natural partners, Prince George's County Public Schools has an incredible creative and visual performing arts programs, and I know Suitland right down the way there has got an outstanding program, and then Benjamin Folloy right around the corner has got a great program as well. So while they may not have been highlighted and showcased like other places, I mean, they're still robust and they're really good, and I only reason I even mention that is, as you talked about partnerships, that's got to be a place where I'm sure the young people can be a part of it and somehow add to the momentum that you've got going there. And I know that there are people on this call who already know that, but I just wanted to add that in case that had gotten kind of forgotten in discussion.
Yeah, I I won't take the credit here. Creative Suitland has been very quiet and very humble, but they have a lot of great partnerships already, and I know they are big supporters of the high schools in the area. So we're really excited to see their education partners in particular and see how we can help them.
Okay, so we're running close to our time. Are there any more questions or suggestions or anything from, I do see Rose. Go ahead, Rose.
Hi, I just wanted to say that I'm so excited about this initiative. I do not live in Suitland, but I am a longtime Prince George's County resident and a champion of our county. I talk about everything that's coming new to our county and let people know that this is a viable place to live and we're on and popping. So I'm excited about this, excited to volunteer and to be able to spread the word about the good things that are coming to our county.
Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate you guys joining us.
All right. I do want to be respectful of people's time. We do have about 5 more minutes. I just want to open it back up to Creative Suitland. Adam, if you want to say anything. And Adam is on the screen. Adam is actually with the Placemaking Section as well. Adam and I are both with the Placemaking Section in the Community Planning Division of the Prince George's County Planning Department. So we've been working at this initiative for a very long time. We have more to come beyond, the 3 pilot projects that we mentioned. And actually, if you go to our project page, you'll see the other locations that we have planned for the pilot projects after Suitland. But we're very excited because we have, a lot of energy, and it's so refreshing to hear all of the passion that you all have around these types of events. And, I'm looking forward to potentially working, with all of you and all the partners that we can to really, advance these types of efforts in the county so that we can rival, other parts of the region that other, people always go to different parts of the region. But like she just said, Prince George's County is the bomb. So, we want to let people know that and do things to show that. So I'm going to hand it off to Brooke and Malachi and Adam to say some final words. So go ahead.
Just to close, I mean, seeing all this in a presentation form just gets me even more excited. And I feel like we felt that, through the chat and a lot of the feedback that we received. So just speaking on behalf of the team, we're definitely looking forward to just going down this process with Better Block and parking planning, just having the amazing partners that you all have been over the past almost 2 years leading into this project, and just excited to just go through this journey, bring the community together, and just have this be a space for everyone to gather. And like we've heard plenty of comments about bringing businesses and marketplaces and other different creative activities. We're looking forward to just receiving all this feedback and implementing this in the best way possible. There were a few people that mentioned that they were not as familiar with Creative Suitland or haven't been to the site. Feel free to, send me an email just to connect. If you want to learn more about the space or how to get involved or more about our programs, feel free to go to our website, which is in the chat. Subscribe to our email listserv so that you can receive weekly emails about what we're bringing to the space and what we're bringing to the community. And if you want to actually tour the space, we actually have a pretty large facility, 2 dance studios, a large theater space, an art gallery, few classrooms, and we do have space for artists that are looking for short-term or long-term space within our building. So we have a pretty open, inviting, comfortable space for all. So feel free to, like I said, connect with us, and in any way that you feel like you can be a part of this movement, feel free to connect, and we really look forward to working with you all. And I'll just hand it over to Brooke.
Well, thank you, everybody. This has been really exciting to get ideas and to meet new people and to know that folks are signing up to volunteer so that this comes to fruition. And I really look forward to finding new partners and continuing to bring the vision of Creative Suitland to its fullest potential, because we've been waiting. So thank you all so much, and thanks so, and a big thank you to everyone at Park and Planning.
And I just want to say thank you for everybody for turning up. We're delighted to be working with such amazing partners, and we really can't wait to get this going with this wonderful community. The energy has been fantastic, and that's only in a virtual environment. So just imagine what it's going to be like when we can all meet in person. So really looking forward to it. Thank you so much.
And with that, I just want to say thank you to you all for joining this call. I can feel the energy. I can feel the excitement, and I look forward to hopefully seeing you all throughout this process, and definitely in April when, you know, we start to activate the actual space of Creative Suitland. So with that, I don't see any more pressing questions or hands raised. So you all have a great evening, and I believe the Kristen shared her email address to get in contact with her. Malachi shared his email address. And I put the project page in the chat, which has the email address to Adam and I with the placemaking team. So with that, have a good night, and I can't wait to partner with you all.